What's up, Steezy fam? We are listening to this song, obviously. I wasn't really prepared to do it. I just did like two other videos back to back, and so I was kind of like, I guess I'm a little caught off guard on how to do the usual intro. But yeah, I'm just trying to listen to this album and give you guys my thoughts. Some of the videos I explain the context of how I got this far along, but I guess you've either seen that or you don't. I don't want to repeat that every time I do a video, but this is the title track. So yeah, let's get into it. I got into a pretty long monologue on the last one, so kind of took a lot out of me. But I definitely have some good energy left for this one. It's just kind of a trip to like be conscious of the difference in headspace. Yeah, it's realizing that as well. That kind of makes me wish I listened to this album in order, but I didn't because I wanted to prioritize the songs that had music videos first because it was YouTube, you know what I mean? But I think in the future, if I ever do an album again, like where I go through the whole album at least, I'll definitely do things in the correct or intended order, I should say. Yeah. Anyway. I'm a little self-conscious about me fidgeting with this shoelace as I'm listening, so I guess I'm gonna put it down. I'm distracting myself.
Since July,
just felt like that melody would repeat again.
Motion capture put me in a bad light.
Sometimes I really don't like it when the lyrical portion and the melody just follow the instrumental melody at the exact in the exact same way, but for some reason it works well for this one right now for me. In this particular moment, for some reason, this stuff is always highly subjective. And I feel like I've made comments like that in other videos, maybe even Taylor Swift ones, and I didn't really have a pleasant reaction necessarily. But this time, I feel like I'm making a similar observation, but I'm enjoying it more, and I don't know why. I also just don't remember what video I'm talking about or why I felt the way I did. But it just feels better in this one for some reason.
I replay my footsteps on each stepping stone, trying to find the one where I went wrong.
Oh, dude, that melody is reminding me. This happens sometimes. I'm trying to listen, and then a melody happens, and it reminds me of some other song. Oh my gosh, what is it? I don't think this one's a Taylor one that it's reminding me of. I'm so sorry that this happens, but it's super, super distracting. And I'm going to be thinking about it, and I feel like it's just on the tip of my tongue, whatever it is.
Trying to find the one where I went wrong. Writing letters.
There's so much pressure right now to know exactly what it is so that I can just move on with the rest of the content. Oh my fucking god. God, dude, it's that fucking song by this dude named Bass Hunter. Oh my god. I'm not gonna pull that video up, but I'm just like upset that that's the video. Oh no, dude. Oh my god. This is a kind of an older music video that was really popular. He was one of those like kind of weird emo dudes or whatever. That was kind of his aesthetic. That blew up on probably like MySpace or something. I don't know exactly. If you guys know Owl City, he's another dude that blew up on MySpace. MySpace was around when like that whole scene thing was kind of a thing. And yeah, this dude named Bass Hunter, which is just so. It just is so what it is. When you see it, if you hear it, you'll know. Let me know in the fucking comment section if you actually went through the trouble to look up Bass Hunter and listen to that song Dota. That's Dota. It's a name of some video game that I never played, but I was wondering what the hell it meant. So I looked it up and now I know. That was a long time ago, but yeah. Oh my god, that's the freaking melody. Oh my lord. Oh my god. If you watch it, you'll understand why I'm having such a weird emotional reaction to that, probably. It's just like that song. Are you freaking? It's so long ago, and it's so like it's so unlike this song. Okay, anyway. I gotta go back a few seconds because Jesus, what a ridiculous tangent, dude. We're gonna start right at where the lyrics pick up. Clean slate. It's a bass hunter. Get over it.
Since July, motion capture put me in a bad light. Replay my footsteps on each stepping stone, trying to find the one where I went wrong. Writing letters addressed to the fire.
Oh, I like that. Address to the
And
fire.
I was catching my breath, staring out an open window, catching my death. And I couldn't be sure. I had a feeling so peculiar that this pain would be for evermore.
Definitely brush up on your vocabulary a little bit listening to Taylor Swift. Is that just the case for the newer stuff, like the last couple of albums? Because again, before I listened to Folklore and Evermore, I was really only exposed to her most like mainstream stuff that you would hear regardless of if you wanted to or not. Like literally just by going outside and existing and ending up in a store or a restaurant or something or some passerby, like you would hear Taylor Swift. And that was basically my exposure to her. And then I explored her on my own, and one thing led to another, and now I'm listening to Folklore and Evermore. But yeah, is that a thing? let me know.
Remember what I used to fight for. I rewind the tape, but all it does is pause on the very moment I was lost, sending signals to be double-crossed. And I was catching my breath, barefoot in the wildest winter, catching my death.
I hope the thing I really respect about Swifties, I feel so silly saying Swifties. Oh my God. I'm just gonna say Taylor Swift fans, and you guys can decide from there whether or not you are Swifties. Right? 'Cause I also feel like Swifties holds like a special caliber. It's not just a word necessarily to be taken lightly. It's probably a word that just holds all kind of weight because I'm sure people use it really insultingly. I'm sure some people call themselves a Swiftie and, have a lot of pride associated with that. I can't call myself one though because I clearly just don't meet the bar to be one. But I feel like I'm slowly like, I've somehow tricked myself into becoming one eventually or something. You know what I mean? Like as I read more comments and I do more reaction videos, like I'm acquiring the knowledge and I'm starting to respect the fans and Taylor and all that stuff. And oh man, it's hilarious. It's very funny. Dude, what was I saying? Oh my God, I totally forgot.
couldn't be sure. I had a feeling so peculiar.
This is a really cool song, by the way, but I have to remember what I was saying. Hopefully it comes to me if I don't remember now. I feel like I was, going on a tangent and then I just sort of forgot where it was. What was I saying? I was talking about how much Taylor Swift fans know. Calling you guys Swifties or whatever and feels silly. Oh my god, dude. I'm so distracted this video. Jeez.
Death. And I couldn't be sure. I had a feeling so peculiar that this pain would be forevermore.
I remember what I was gonna say. I was saying, I hope that since you guys are such hardcore fans, especially the self-proclaimed Swifties and whatnot, I hope that you guys are doing the music justice on nice headphones or something, because sometimes the production value really merits speakers or headphones that does it justice. Because I'm able to hear some details that would, it kind of bums me out to think about how many of the people that are listening just don't hear that. Partly because they're not listening for it, but also partly because they're listening to the music in such a way that just doesn't make it easy to hear. I mean, these are all things that are heavily layered. They're definitely not on the face of this song's identity or anything like that, but they're back there and they're very nice, these harmonies and whatnot. So yeah, I'm sure some of you guys are, but I hope, I hope everybody gets that chance too. Obviously, like, some of the speakers and headphones and stuff just aren't cheap at all, but if you have some decent headphones or something, really try to listen to the harmonies and whatnot. They're quite nice, and it's always something that I try to pay attention to when I'm listening to music. And yeah, every now and then some songs just do it so well, and I'm kind of feeling that in this one right now, because there isn't a whole lot going on instrumentally and musically in this one, but the layerings are very nice. Just try to listen for a quiet voice behind the lead vocals. Just try to keep an ear out for when it happens and what it's doing. Is it different on the left or the right side? Like, when it happens, when it stops. If it's lower or if it's higher. If she's speaking more softly or speaking more loudly, but the volume is really quiet, It's, I don't know, details like that, I guess.
Think of all the cost, all the things that will be lost. Or can we just get a pause to be certain we'll be tall again? Where the weather be the frost, or the violence of the dark days. I'm on waves, I'll be in tall. Go cross. And when I was shipwrecked, I thought of you. All the things that will be lost now. In the cracks of light, just get apart. I dreamed of you. To be certain we'll be told to be the good. And it was real enough to get me through.
This section of the song, back and forth, is a previous Bon Iver featured track. And the back and forth is kind of similar. I guess they enjoy working with each other on songwriting, I imagine. Because, yeah, he's in several tracks as Bon Iver. Has anyone else, really dug into Bon Iver's work? I tried to a while ago. I forget what it was. I think it was some album that was allegedly recorded in some, cabin in some forest and kind of in the middle of nowhere or something like that. And this is a while ago, and I just wasn't really feeling it or something. And I was had some friends that really were, and I just didn't really get into it. And I probably didn't give it a fair chance or something, but sometimes music just gets you, or you get it, and that just wasn't one of those moments. But yeah, I'm curious if you guys are familiar with Bon Iver's work, Or if, like, these features really brought this person to your attention or not, and then you became a fan through this or whatnot. I'm just curious what your guys' association is, because clearly Taylor has chosen to work with Bon Iver for several tracks. I really like that song, but sometimes the Bon Iver stuff I have mixed feelings about. I think that's part of the sound signature, is just kind of like auto-tuned, heavily harmonized lyrics and melodies. Just kind of, I don't know, maybe it threw me off a little bit, but otherwise, I for sure really like the layering of the song. I'd go back and listen to that one. I think I should, actually, because I definitely got a little bit distracted, and first time listening to a song, it's hard to get the whole message and everything and piece it together while you're also paying attention to the music and you're also doing a reaction video at the same time. So I think I will go back and listen to this one, and I do sort of plan to do like some kind of album review, like where at the end of these reviews I will talk about the album, and I think it's good. Maybe for me to do it in one video where I sort of compare my thoughts on Evermore and Folklore. And I might go back and listen to the albums like right back to back or something, or just sort of in my head, like try to remember how I felt, and base a comparison on that or something. But to be fair, I probably should listen to the tracks in order, from start to finish, in the order of the album release as well, and then kind of see how I feel. I don't know if it's even really like sensible to compare the first or Folklore to Evermore, like is that even a comparison that I should do? Is one supposed to be better than the other? Because I feel like they're more of a pair, aren't they? It's not necessarily like one is supposed to be better than the other. It's kind of like one leads into the other. So mixed feelings about how I would go about doing a video review about that. But if you guys have thoughts on that, let me know in the comments section. Because I'm still thinking about it, so it's a good time to get your ideas in if you have them. But one thing I probably won't do is actually sit here for I don't know however many hours it would take, because I just don't have the attention span to literally listen all the way through for two whole albums as I'm reacting to them. That would be such a long video. And it would never clear copyright, because it'd literally be, I don't know, however, like 40 songs that would have to be cleared for the copyright. I think it would just get banned. I don't think my video would ever get uploaded. So I'd probably just reflect on it after recently listening. We'll see. We'll see. But if you have ideas, do let me know in the comment section. Just remember, keep in mind what I just said, because that is an idea that I definitely won't do, but anything else I might be open to. So let me know. Thanks for watching, and thank you for subscribing. And gonna be hitting that 500 mark eventually, I suppose. I sure hope so. Got to think of some kind of thing to reveal or something. I want to do something a little bit like celebratory. We'll think about that. Anyway, I might be calling it a night here because it is like 2 something in the morning and I just happen to be feeling kind of like it's time to wind down, but we'll see. Yeah, we'll see. But yeah, thanks again for watching and I'll see you guys in the next one as usual. Bye for now.